Hello everybody, welcome to a new series of videos giving you tips and tricks on how to use Contentful. We want you to be more productive using Contentful. So if you want us to cover any particular topic, let us know. And by the way, I'm Stefan. I work at the developer relations team at Contentful. And what I want to show you today is something I'm really, really excited about. Recently, we released a new CLI tool. We got a lot of feedback and we took it seriously. It is like it is. Power users spend their time on the command line. So we wanted to make it as easy as possible to not force you to leave the terminal. In this tutorial, I want to show you how you can quickly get started using the Contentful CLI. Let me show you how this works. Contentful CLI is an NPM package that you can install globally. So let's head over to my terminal and do that. So let's type npm I, which is short for install, minus g, Contentful CLI. The minus g is for installing this module globally. This now will take a moment. All right, done. So let's check if we have the new Contentful command available by typing in which Contentful. Sweet, I'm using NVM here. This stands for Node Version Manager, and it helps me to keep track of different node versions on the same machine. Your path might be different, and that's totally fine, as long as it's defined. So what can we do with this CLI tool? We can see all the available commands by just executing the new Contentful command. Okay, so we can download boilerplates, there is a getting started guide, log in and log out, and a command to manage spaces. Cool. What you usually do when you use Contentful in your apps is that you use the Content Delivery API to fetch your data. This API is built to scale, heavily cached, and read-only. Contrary, Contentful CLI uses the Content Management API. This API allows you to create new spaces, configure content types, write data to your spaces, and much, much more. And to use this API, you have to get a Content Management token and then authorize the CLI. And this is exactly what the login command does. So let's do it. The login command will now ask me to open a new browser window so that I can log into Contentful for authorization. So let me just use my private account here. Cool. What you see now is the dialog to authorize an application with Contentful. And as you see, this application will then be able to manage content in all the spaces I have. This is exactly what we want to do from the command line. So let's authorize. This is a token that allows the CLI tool to perform write operations. You can simply hit the copy button because you need the token in a moment anyways, to save it in the Contentful CLI tool. So let's go back to the terminal. And the CLI prompt is already waiting for the access token. So let's paste it and hit enter. Great, the CLI is ready to use and we can now perform write operations. You might ask yourself, well, Stefan, but where's this token stored now? We decided to follow the .file approach. So you can find your token in your home directory in a hidden file that is called .contentfulrc.json. So when we have a quick look into it using the cat command, you will find the token in there. Certain commands included in the CLI require a space ID. This means that I could now append a minus minus space ID to every command, but I can also define a default space for my operations. I can do that using the contentful space use command. As you can see, it lists all the spaces that are available in my private Contentful account. So let's choose the space that is powering my private website. Cool. And the CLI is now telling me that it's falling back to the space when I'm not defining a specific space ID. So let's check one of the commands. What are these boilerplates about? The goal of the boilerplates is to show you what you can do with Contentful. Let's give it a try. You see that there are boilerplates for Android, Swift, PHP, Ruby, and a few other languages available. I prefer to write JavaScript though, so I'll choose the JavaScript boilerplate here. And as you see, the CLI already automates a few things. It creates a new Content Delivery API token, downloads some source code in a zip file, and writes it to my current working directory. Cool. So, what's in there now? To have a look, let's unzip the file using the unzip command, and let's navigate into the extracted folder, install the dependencies using npm install, and open it in my editor of choice. In this case, it's Visual Studio Code. Let's open the index.js file and see what's going on. You can see the CLI already set the correct space ID and the newly created access token. These two values are needed to initialize the Contentful JavaScript SDK client, which happens here. And then there's a function called run boilerplate, which is called right at the bottom of the file. Inside of this function, you can see several function calls. The functions display content types and display entries will display all the content types and all the entries that are available in the space that is powering my own website. And when we have a look at these two functions, we see that they're using the JavaScript SDK under the hood. To fetch all the content types, client get content types is used, and to fetch entries of a certain content type, client get entries is called with a certain content type. This shows that the SDK is a big help when fetching data from the API. Cool. Are you ready to see what is included in the space that powers my personal website? So, let's execute everything by running npm start. Wow, there's a lot of stuff going on now. As expected, it shows the content types. You now see I'm using content types for posts, talks, events, and many others. And it also shows me the given entries. When we want to look up, for example, the blog post I've written, we can scroll down and see all the blog posts right here. The boilerplates in your language of choice help you to see how the particular SDK works so that you've got an easier start. But the Contentful CLI gives you way more functionality than just boilerplates. I recommend you to play around with it, because there's another thing I'm really excited about. It's a command that helps you to set up a new web project in only a few minutes. I have to say, though, that I'll show you this one in the next episode. It's tough to wait. I know. So, that's it for today. This is the Contentful CLI, and I hope you start playing around with it. There's way more stuff included than just boilerplates. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any feedback, please let me know. So, see you next time.